Welcome to Yelm Community Schools Family Access Tips. With fall conferences coming up, we wanted to be able to provide a quick resource on how to sign up for fall conferences for your students in Family Access. You'll see I'm in a training database with false students and false family records, just to not disclose any private family information. This is all fake data. From here, I'm on the home or landing page of Family Access, and there's a couple ways to get to conferences. The number one thing I want to encourage is to look for the open untils. These are open registrations for upcoming conferences. So you'll see I actually bypassed the conferences section and went straight to these windows that highlight the upcoming conference. Now, I labeled these fall conferences in the fake database, but it will mirror this icon and will tell you that it is a conference and what date range you can sign up till. Make sure you sign up as soon as possible and before the deadline. The sooner you sign up, the more likely you'll be able to get preferred time with your students' teachers. With that, I have two, one for each student. And I'll go ahead and click on this first one. This first one is for Aurelia, who is in elementary school, grade 2. And in this one, I can see any current conflicts. So these are all the classes that Aurelia has. This is their teacher. And really, it's the same class. It's just that the teacher teaches multiple subjects. On the right, I can see that the teacher has two conflicts already. So what I would do is pick an available time. Once I find a time that I like, I can use this green plus to add that time. I can delete if I'm not ready to schedule that time, and then leave a note for the teacher as well. If you need to leave a quick message, some availability, some additional notes for the teacher, you can do that here. And you can print schedule now. However, you can also do it after you click done scheduling. So I'm going to model that by clicking done scheduling. And when you are complete, you should see your conferences have been scheduled, and you'll be able to see all of those conferences for all of your students and print that schedule. So this isn't just for the one student, this is actually for all of the students I have in the household. I'll go and model, clicking print schedule. Gives me a quick pop-up. And that pop-up will show up in your browser or in your downloads folder directly. With that, I'm going to go back to the home screen and highlight a different way to get to conferences. I can click on the next option in order to navigate to conferences for my other student. I can also use the menu or hamburger to go to conference, and then click on the conferences. This is, would be the same route as if on the home screen I clicked on this conferences live tile. So let me go and click on that. From here, I can see my different students, the conference dates, and then I can navigate into or go into or edit that student's record. So I see we already scheduled times with Aurelia. I'm going to go ahead and edit Nikolai. And I see that Nikolai currently has two times with two different teachers. And I can go ahead and edit the conference schedule on the right. And I see that I actually have a checkbox next to each teacher that I already have a scheduled time with. And I have one that is currently not scheduled. I went ahead and clicked on that final teacher. On the right, I'm going to scroll down to find that available time and use the plus icon to then complete their schedule. With that, I'll go ahead and hit done scheduling. This has been a quick look at scheduling conference times. As you get closer to the date, be sure to communicate with your teacher and/or building staff that your students are registered, to ensure any schedule changes, so that we can make sure that we have the maximum availability for all of our families and students. Thank you, and have a good day.